So Jayananda Maharaj asked me to choose one subject today.
Radhe, Radhe.
Yes, and something come into my mind that I'm thinking about for some time. To discuss the five most important practices in bhakti. And Jayananda, he told me that this subject is discussed in the verse 55 of Radha, Rasa, Sudhanidhi. So we will read that and then go in the sharing of these five most important practices of bhakti, or most powerful practices. So we are reading Radha, Rasa, Sudhanidhi, verse 55. May my mind always dwell in Radha's tender lotus feet as I loudly and very affectionately sing Hari's name to her, serve her with many perfumed paraphernalia, and most blissfully follow her in Vrindavan. Bhajana in Braja. Commentary. This verse is spoken in external consciousness, sadaka vesh. Srila Rupa Goswami has mentioned the five most powerful items of devotion in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Quote, these confidential items of devotions, living in Braja, worshipping the deity and chanting the holy name, are so powerful that if an offenseless person practices them even a little bit, even unconsciously or without faith, Bhav will take birth in his heart. These five extraordinary items of sadhana have such inconceivable powers that they simultaneously reveal Bhava and its object, Sri Krishna, in the heart of the sadhaka. So here we can already start our sharing. So Rupa Goswami mentions this most powerful items of bhakti as they are Sadhu Sangha, Bhagavat Katha, chanting the holy name, worshipping the deity, and living in Braja. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also, or in Chaitanya Charitamrita, is also mentioned. In Madhya Lila, 22nd chapter, verse 128, Sadhu Sangha, Nama Kirtan, Bhagavat Shravana, Mathura Vasa, Srimutira Shradaya Sevana. One should associate with devotees, chant the holy name of the Lord, hear Srimad Bhagavatam, reside at Mathura, and worship the deity with faith and veneration. So, the first thing is Sadhu Sangha. And I was thinking that there is a deeper meaning of Sadhu Sangha. For me, it doesn't just mean that we have association with sadhus, but for me it means also that we have a guru, that we find a guru and take shelter in the guru and take initiation from him. So, Jayananda, you want to comment on that?
Yeah, but at first you can share your feeling, you know, about Sadhu Sangha, and then here also Radha Charanji, also but whoever, you know, and yeah, comment. That's also very good.
Yeah.
So I want to hear your experience, your realization and your feeling about Sadhu Sangha, these five items.
Okay. So yes, Sadhu Sangha for me sounds it's little general speaking. But we have to connect deeper. And Sadhu Sangha means also to get instructions from the sadhu, get initiated by a sadhu and surrender to a sadhu, become a disciple, a student, willing to learn about bhakti. So Sadhu Sangha sounds little general speaking, but for me meaning is also Guru Pada Ashray, take shelter and a bona fide spiritual master and get initiation from him. Then the second one is Nam Kirtan, chanting the holy name. So we are chanting the holy name, the Maha Mantra, but there are different bhavas included in the Maha Mantra. And I think chanting of the holy name means also with relation. There has to be a sambandha and the abhideya and the prayojan. Only if that happens, only if we get diksha, then the process of chanting can be fruitful. When I choose this subject, I was thinking that these five most powerful practices in bhakti, that they are also interrelated with each other. For me, there is a direct connection between Sadhu Sangha and Nam Kirtan, meaning getting Diksha from a bona fide spiritual master that establishes our connection, our sambandha, and teaching us the way in Abhideya, and can show and bring us also to the goal, to the prayoja. So I see there's a direct direction, direct connection between Sadhu Sangha and Nam Kirtan. So the number three is Bhagavad Katha, listening from Srimad Bhagavatam. So we are not reading so much Srimad Bhagavatam. We are reading Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi, Vilap Kusumanjali, Chaitanya Charitamrita, other books of the Goswamis. So what is the meaning of Bhagavad Katha? And I want to share a story that I read recently. Gaura Govinda Maharaj is telling the story of Bhakti Devi. Narada Muni is traveling on the earth, and he is meeting the four Kumaras, and Narad is very sad. And the Kumaras asking him, Narada, what happened to you? And Narada say, oh, I was wandering all the planet, but Kali Yuga has started. And there's no jnana, no tapasya, no bhakti. Everything is disturbed and polluted. But he also went to Vrindavan, and there he saw a young lady sitting near the Yamuna, and left and right to her, there was two old men. And Narada asking, who are you? And the lady said, I am Bhakti Devi, and these are my two sons, Jnana and Vairagya. So the meaning is that in Vrindavan, Bhakti is always young and fresh. Bhakti always lives in Vrindavan. So this is a long story, but I want to mention one point that is in connection with listening to Srimad Bhagavatam is very important. Narada Muni listen a voice from the heaven that he should do sat karma, practice sat karma. But Narada Muni, he didn't know what that is, and that he has to meet some sadhus that can explain to him what that sat karma is. So when Narada Muni was meeting afterwards the four Kumaras, they told him, my dear Narad, sat karma, the eternal activity, is to listen Srimad Bhagavatam. Then Narada Muni, he said, wow. I'm back again?
Yes. Okay.
Sorry. So then Radha Muni here was telling to them that he chanted the Upanishads and the Gita, Bhagavad Gita, into the ears of the two sons, Vairagya and Jnana. But he could not revive them, even by listening Bhagavad Gita. And the Kumaras told him, Satkarma means listening Bhagavatam. So why the Bhagavatam works and not the Gita? And I was thinking that actually, Bhagavatam means to enter into Raga Bhakti. Teachings of Bhagavad Gita as a neophyte person, jiva, will bring you to the assignment that Gurudev always is talking about. That after Bhagavad Gita, you accept that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead and that you want to surrender to Him and that you want to start a relation with Him. But Bhagavad Gita not explaining more details. And Bhagavatam is different. Bhagavatam from the first canto up to the 10th canto bring you to the pinnacle of leaving Vairi Bhakti and enter into Raga Bhakti, to enter into Vrindavan. So Bhagavatam is going up to Sakhi Bhav, Gopi Bhav. Rasa Lila in Bhagavatam is the pinnacle of the Bhagavatam. So that could be spoken by the parrot of Srimati Radharani Sukadev Goswami. More he also could not speak. And by the mercy of Mahaprabhu and the Goswamis, Rupa, Sanatan, Raghunath, we get even more knowledge. So I would say that Bhagavatam, Bhagavat Katha, here one of the most powerful items means generally entering Raga Bhakti, become a Rasika Vaishnava. And then in more detail, we in our Rupa Nuga Sampradaya, we are listening more detail. In Vilap Kusumanjali and Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi. So, I want to make the point that you have to understand deeper what is the meaning of Bhagavad Katha. It doesn't mean only Srimad Bhagavatam, but it means Shastra, reading and listening from Shastra, that are in the realm of Raga Bhakti, and in our case, in the Rupa Nuga Sampradaya. So, yes, that is what I understood from listening or from reading this Bhagavad Katha as one of the most powerful practices in bhakti. Then we have the next one. So, and also there's a connection between Bhagavad, between chanting and between Sadhu Sangha. Because we need to listen. This Bhagavad Katha, our Shastras, Vilap Kusumanjali, everything, we need to listen from a real sadhu, from our guru, from whom we got diksha and connection. And we have also to chant and listen, reading Bhagavad Katha and doing kirtan, chanting. It is also related to each other. You cannot exclude one of these items. If one is missing, then our sadhana cannot bear fruits. It is not complete. So Sadhu Sangha, Nam Kirtan, Bhagavad Katha, it's a must. It goes together with each other. And the next one is worshipping the deity with love and faith. So, in general, that can mean that deity worship. But for me, deeper meaning is that you serve your Ishtadev. Worshipping the deity is also a little general speaking. I feel that deeper meaning of that is that you have Ishtadev. Ishtadev also means, one meaning or translation, the form of God for whose pleasure I exist. So meaning is, we exist, our existence is to give happiness to Radha Mohan. If Radha Mohan is your Ishtadev, so deity worship is also not just worshipping a deity in the temple. It means to worship and serve your Ishtadev with relation. And again, that is also connected with Sadhu Sangha, with Guru Para Ashray, Gurudev giving me the Ishtadev, Gurudev by Diksha He connects me. He established the sambandha. He is teaching me how to serve the Ishtadev and how to fix myself, what to practice, what is my goal of sadhana. And the last one of this most, five most powerful items is living in Braja, Mathura Vas. So I'm thinking, where you find the sadhu, no? The sadhu is living in the holy place. You travel to holy places because you want to see the sadhus. Without sadhus, the dham, the holy place, is locked for us. Yes, we can visit the holy place, and certainly there is a different vibration, and it is very auspicious to be there, and you get blessings to do service. But the sadhu really can open the door to the divine dham, to the divine Vrindavan. They can enter into the lila that happens now, always, in Vrindavan. Gurudev always saying, pastime is not a good word. Because past means it's over, but it's not. It's happening now. And the sadhu, guru, can open the door for us to enter that divine Vrindavan. And our Acharyas, Rupa and Raghunath, they also revealed the divine Vrindavan to us in their books. So, and yes, of course, living in Vrindavan, it's more by the mind and with your heart than just with the body. You can be in Vrindavan by body, but your mind and your heart still can be outside. Then it is not living in Vrindavan. But maybe all of your bodies, people that are watching now here in the Zoom, the body maybe is not in Vrindavan now, but your heart and your mind is in Vrindavan. So you are living in Vrindavan by your feelings, by your love, by your meditation. And Narayan Maharaj, he so beautifully explained that when the mind is living in Vrindavan all the time, then surely the body has to follow in the future. If your mind is always in Vrindavan, then the body will go there also, 100%, and start living there. So I choose the subject because I felt like that all these five items, Sadhu Sangha, Naam Kirtan, Bhagavad Katha, worship of the deity, and Mathura Vas, living in Vrindavan, that they are all related to each other. They are interconnected with each other. Yes, and that I wanted to share with you. So now,
very please beautiful. Share. Very beautiful, Gaurachandana. So, thank you very much, Gaurachandana. So, I wish to hear, here is Radha Charan Baba there. So, if you could speak about this subject.
Radhe, can you hear me?
Can you hear?
Radhe. Okay. I want to speak about Sadhu Sangha because it's a root cause of bhakti. Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastra Khoi, Lava Matra, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Khoi. This verse from Chaitanya Charitamrita. In this verse, Shri Krishna Kaviraj Goswami telling what just by
louder, please.
Lava Matra. Lava Matra is a very small particle of time, very small, like one blinking, not more. And
sorry, the voice is very low. Please, a little louder.
Radhe.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Srila Krishna Kaviraj Goswami telling what Sadhu Sangha is so powerful, what even one small particle of time, like one blinking, this time, not more, enough to receive Sarva Siddhi. Sarva Siddhi means prema, love, divine love, is enough to receive this very rare gift. And the question is coming, what Sadhu Sangha, we just read here in commentary, it's so powerful, what even person without faith, not understanding what he is doing, he receiving bhava in heart by Sadhu Sangha. And who is this Sadhu? Who is this Sadhu? My first idea was when I heard this, verse, Sadhu is a great Vaishnava who is really to attain, he is living in Vraj, doing his bhajan, Rasika Vaishnava. It's true. But now I'm thinking, this Sadhu is Jananda Maharaj, Mahatma, his wife Sadhvi, and Gaharvan Lila. Yeah? All these devotees with Sadhu, because they all hold Ananda Babaji Maharaj written Bhaktavira. They come through so many obstacles, so many difficult situations, so many churning in their hearts to Srimati Radhika. And they, in their heart, great treasure of feelings. And here in Mangera Mandir, in Vrindavan, Yoga Maya is so powerful. She is arranging our meeting. Is each other and found the friends here, someone with whom we can be very, very close. Children Gosai Maharaj explained who is Bhajna Shiksha Guru. Usually, what I know about Guru, Guru is that person who is giving Diksha, initiation, he has so position, what I have some natural respect, some fear, at least at beginning. But Bhajan Shiksha Guru, he's explained, is such a person, he's just a friend, your friend. You're not feeling any obstacle to narrate to him about everything what you have in the heart. Any situation you love in your life, you can openly tell to him without any obstacle, such a person. In same time, he has so nice experience, so nice feelings towards you, towards Srimati Radhika, what he can help. He can tell exactly what you needed. And it's so natural and so close relationship, a real natural friendship, human friendship. In this friendship, because of this close relationship, feelings coming so nicely from heart to heart. It's written in Srimad Bhagavatam about sadhusanga. What does mean sadhusanga? Satam prasanga mama virya sambidho. Then satam. Satam means that person who is living in sat, in eternity. Means who his heart so much attached to Srimati Radhika. He already gave his heart to Srimati Radhika. And then someone has friendship with such person. Satam prasanga. Prasanga means directly from the heart to the heart, feelings coming. Very naturally and easily. What is why it's telling even Lava Matra, so small particle, the Bhava, real feelings coming from the heart, one person to other person. I found very interesting effect when I come to Gurudev morning time to read. We are all coming to read with him. I found this time is so special for me. From begin, from first time when I came to here, when I started to come morning time reading, for me it's time beyond of this world. My nature changing completely. What is happening with me, no possible without this. Then after reading, I'm going to the room, I'm again in this world with my mind and so on. But when I'm reading, when I'm with Gurudev, I'm completely different. I'm completely in other world. It's so, so interesting. And feelings coming, strong feelings, desires, spiritual desires. Then after you're starting to chant Harinam with these desires and Harinam fulfilling these desires. Satam Prasanga. Prasanga means what, so close and direct association from heart to heart. And what they're speaking? They're speaking about the greatest attachment in the heart to the Ishta Devata. Mamavirya Samvedo. Krishna is telling. They're telling about my heroic actions. What's the heroic action? How he tried to get Srimati Radhika in Jatila's house, for example. So many obstacles. What he is doing, so many things he is creating just to come inside of house. Or to meet with her in Kunja. Or Srimati Radhika in Man. How many things he is doing to overcome this man and makes them both happy. Krishna's Mama Virya, he's telling, they're speaking about my heroic. And I think also it's heroic action, not only about Krishna. They are reading here the saints of Raja once in a week. It's also, I think, heroic actions of heroic Vaishnavas. Mama Virya Bhakta, Virya Bhakta. What they did. Srila Raghunatha Goswami. What he did all his life, all devotees. And we are speaking about Srimati Radhika, we are speaking about her beloved, how it's written here. Let my mind be always at the tender lotus feet of Radha. And in such a way, what I can always can loudly and with passion heart to sing for her the names of Hari. Means they're speaking not only about Srimati Radhika, they're speaking about her beloved also and about they manjaris, their devotees. This is Mama Virya Samvedo. And this Bhavati Hrit Karnarasayana Katha, these Katha, these narrations coming through the ears and giving to the ears nectar. It's called Rasayana. Rasayana is medical term. It's such liquid which is giving life. It's giving energy. It's enlivening. Rasayana, it's so tasty, so much rasa in this. And it's giving life to the ears and coming to the heart. And if heart has injury, it will be cured. It's medicine, best medicine. And so much rasa. Mama Virya Samvido Bhavanti Hrit Karna Rasayana Katha Tadjoshanat Ashwapavargavatmani. This devotee easily overcome all samsara. Before, samsara looks like endless ocean. Many, many thousands birth and death in one cycle. In this cycle, soul in one birth coming through so many pain just to receive one, two good qualities. And gradually, gradually, it's coming to the top of universe, become demigod. And then again, samsara, it seems like no end. But here it's telling, then such harikatha coming to the ears. Bas, finish, no more samsara. No more samsara. Apavargavartmani, no more fear, no more heavy labor without any understanding why I'm doing, why I'm so much suffering, and just as just carrying this, all these heavy things. And then Shraddha, Ratir, Bhaktir, Anukramishti. Anukramishti means gradually, step by step. Shraddha, faith coming. Just this person is came without Shraddha, it's written here. He came to the sadhu without Shraddha. I remember here two persons came. They are Christian. They are followers of Jesus. They are not following our books. And they started to assist with Gurudev and they attached to him. And they discuss all this subject about love, about how natural this way of love. They so attached. At the end, they ask him about initiation. I saw here it's happened. It's so powerful, Harikatha of Sadhu. How he, it's not lectures, academical lectures. He's just sharing his feelings, his bhavas. He, how to say, very magnificently giving opportunity to be in his reality. Shuddhasattva visheshatma, be in his reality. How, what does mean Vraj? What does mean love? What is happening there? So many jokes, so many nice things happening. And then Shraddha, desire coming. Desire, I won't be where, I won't be with all these sweet personalities, I won't serve them. Shraddha, Ratir, passion, strong desire to serve, and then Bhakti, Prema Bhakti, Anukramishti, gradually, step by step, just by hearing such nice Harikatha. If you once hear, bus, you couldn't stop. Radha, Radha, what are you thinking about Sadhu Sangha? Radhe.
So thank you very much, Radha Charanji. So Gora Chandra Prabhu explained so nicely, and Radha Charan Prabhu explained the power of Sadhu Sangha. So I have heard and I have read many times in this matter. And among these five items, every item is so powerful. One item we could get perfection. But especially this Sadhu Sangha is most important. Also, Mathura Bhas also very important. That's what I'm feeling. And this Sadhu Sangha, so Gora Chandra and Radha Charam explain. I feel different kind of sadhu. Some sadhu may be impersonal realization, someone who has sadhu. And some person has a Vaidhi Bhakta. Some person has a doing Raganuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhakta. Or someone who has a Rupanuga Bhakta. And of course, different sadhu association give us different fruits. Because goal is different. So Gaurachandra say, we are following Rupanuga. And Gaurachandra explained very nicely. This Bhagavata Shravana. Generally speaking, Bhagavata is Shrimad, is mean Shrimad Bhagavatam. But my feeling is like this. Bhagavata Shravana is whatever related is Bhagavata, like a Bhagavan or a Vaishnava, especially without Radhika, Bhagavan is not full. So that means this Bhagavata Shravana, my feelings, including of course Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi and Virapaka Samanjari, in highest meaning. So Gaurachandra explained very nicely, if we read or hear Bhagavatam, first canto to ninth canto explain Vaidhi Bhakti, Narayan worship, Vishnu worship. And then finally Shukadeva explain Vrajababa. And finally among the Vrajabasi, the devotee Vraja, who is highest? Then Bhagavata say Gopi Gita, 10th canto, 29 chapter to 33 chapter. This mentioned, yes, Gopi's Baba is highest. And then among the Gopi, who is highest Bhakta, highest Gopi? But Bhagavatam, fortunately or unfortunately, did not mention the name. But Goswami's revealed this Gopi, highest Gopi, is Srimati Radharani. So that means we may understand conclusion of Srimad Bhagavatam is worshipping the Radhika, which Bhagavatam does not mention directly. So Shukadeva tried to give point. What kind of bhakti is highest? And Vraja Bhakti. Among the Vraja Bhakti, Gopi's Baba, Gopi's feeling the highest. Among the Gopi's feeling, Radhika's feeling highest. This is my feeling, is Bhagavatam's conclusion. So, therefore, Sadhu Sangha is if someone who could associate Radhika's devotee, it may be, we may say, is highest. So, and this Sadhu Sangha, I feel, this is Sajati Sangha, same goal, same feeling, that devotee's association is most valuable. I remember one day, Gurudev Sadhu Maharaj told us, if you have five Siddha friends, you become Siddha. Gurudev said, if you have five person who is Siddha, then you will be Siddha. So Gurudev told us like this. So this is the association so important, because this Sadhu Sangha, at least as a three or four item automatically comes. Here Vrindavan, we can have everything. Therefore, Mathura verse is very important. Why say this Mathura Bhasa? Because Mathura, this say broad meaning of Braja. Not only small meaning of Mathura. Then, question may arise, why Mathura? Why Braja? Our devotees, Gaudiya Vaishnava devotees, want to live three places. Gaudiya Vaishnava likes especially three places. One is Navadvip, because Mahaprabhu was doing a pastime until marriage life. And then another is Jagannatha Puri, because Mahaprabhu staying Jagannatha Puri after took sannyas. And also another is Braja, because Mahaprabhu want to visit Braja, and he did visit Braja. But among the three, I feel Braja is highest. Why is that? Because if our goal fix one point, Radha Mohan's seva, especially Radha's seva, then Braja is most suitable. So Gaurachandra also mentioned, in Braja, where sadhu most lives? Braja. Especially Radha's maid servant lives, most devotee lives in Braja. Of course, other holy place also may, especially Navadvip, you know, but especially in Vrindavan, many worshippers of Radhika and many Rupanuga devotees. So, therefore, Braja is so important, and also Gurudev mentioned why Braja is important, because Braja is in the influence of Yoga Maya. So, if we stay in Braja, automatically we have in spiritual consciousness, and automatically we could hear Radha's name and also Radha's Mohan's name, also Radha's kata, Radha's Mohan's kata, and also Gaurachandra Prabhu mentioned Archana. So we go erotic. Here Gurudev suggests go erotic. Why is that? So then Gaurachandra say, this Ishtadeva, relationship of our worship of deity and the seva of Ishtadeva, relationship Ishtadeva, this is the most important thing. Because if we don't know the relationship of our Ishtadeva, then what to do? Even we may hear, we may chanting, but if we don't have a relationship with Ishtadeva, it's not so very good. We may not attain perfection. So this Sadhu Sangha is available especially in Braja, Vrindavan. And Braja, also Nama Kirtan is going on. Also Bhagavata Shravana and Harikata is going on. And also Archana is going on. Then people may think, oh, I'm staying outside Vrindavan. I'm staying in Europe or you know, Japan or United States or South America. So what to do? But Mahaprabhu kindly give us, Mahaprabhu, I forgot which shastra, maybe Chaitanya Bhagavata or some other shastra. Mahaprabhu distribute his devotee all over the world. Especially Prabhupada did Prabhupada went to the United States and Prabhupada sent devotees all over the world. And then we may found, now I guess almost each country probably we may find some kind of sadhu. This is a very important thing. Especially someone who carried in Vrindavan, someone who has carried Radha Mohan in the heart. That is real sadhu. And whenever sadhu goes, that place become Vrindavan. Like Gurudev Sadhu Maharaj, wherever he goes, that place become like Vrindavan. Why that? Because Sadhu Maharaj always carry Radha Mohan in the heart. Also, the fragrance and taste and Braja Baba, Manjari Baba, he has. So, if we go to abroad, outside Braja, we try to do these five items. And then slowly, slowly, our mind, our consciousness fixing. I'm feeling, why am I staying in Braja? This answer might be to get Sadhu Sangha, to get Nama Kirtan, do bhajan, and do hearing Radha Rasa Sandhi Virapaksa Manjari from Gurudev or other Rashika Vaishnava. And also to establish relationship with our Ishtadeva. Especially to stay Braja, fix ourselves one point. Especially for us, Babo Urasa, we want to get Manjari Baba or Kinkari Baba. So this verse is very nice. Again, I want to read verse. May my mind always dwell in Radha's tender lotus feet, as I loudly and very affectionately sing Hari's name to her, serve her with many perfumed paraphernalia, and most blissfully follow her in Vrindavan. Actually, these five items, Manjari does. Manjari does association with other Manjari or senior Sakis. And Manjari does always Nama Kirtan, Manjari chanting always Radha's name. Or sometimes Radha's Mohan's name. Manjari does Radha Mohan's kata. Where is Mohan? What Mohan is doing? What the Radhika is doing? This is their conversation. Archana, yoga pit, Manjari or Saki worshipping the Radha's, Radha and Radha's Mohan. And Manjari stay always in Braja. So I feel these five items, Radha's dasi, Manjari is doing. So therefore, we want to follow Rupa Raghunatha. Rupa Manjari and Torashi Manjari. Radhe Radhe. Thank you very much. Or anybody want to some comments and sharing? I don't know who is there. So we are welcome anybody to share.
Yeah, because of this, because Manjari doing that, because of this, Baba in the purport talking about this, no? In the sloka, there are three things mentioned. Being in Vrindavan, chanting the name, and serving my beloved deity, no? Serving Radharani.
Mm.
And of course, always listening and not alone. My Guru Manjari is always there. Other Manjaris are there. So Sadhu Sangha always also is there. Yeah. In Sadak and in Siddha. Same practice. Okay, I'm we'll continue reading a little, huh?
Yeah, that's better. Then we can share, we can feel, we can taste what Baba mentioned, this five important items. And what that Manjari is feeling.
These five extraordinary items of sadhana have such inconceivable powers that they simultaneously reveal bhava and its object, Sri Krishna, in the heart of the sadhaka. The holy name is the greatly merciful avatar of the Lord, appearing in the form of transcendental syllables. Srila Jiva Goswami writes in Bhagavad Sandhava 48. Srimad Rupa Goswami Pad has written in his Sri Krishna Namastaka, quote, "The toenails of the holy name are being worshipped by the luster that emanates from the jewel strings of the crown ornaments of all the Vedic scriptures. From this, we can understand that Sri Rupa did not see the form of the holy name as mere syllables, but he perceived a sweet and beautiful form endowed with hands and feet." Srimad Jiva Goswami has written, quote, "The holy name is the embodiment of bliss, just like the original form of the Lord. This is the experience in the hearts of the great saints." So Maharaj, I have a question. The holy name and its object, Krishna, here, they are identical or they are not identical? Because the holy name has a form and Krishna also has a form. It sounds like not 100% identical. What is your opinion?
You want to say something?
Radha-charan.
Yeah, I ask Radha-charan.
Jananda asked me to answer.
Yes, please.
If I will tell from my own experience, I think no difference between Krishna and his name, or Radha and her name. But in same time, the holy name is more merciful. It's coming to us with everything, form, test, qualities, lilas, everything, holy name coming. By the mercy it's coming. Krishna and Srimati Radhika always in Vrindavan, they always in their lilas in Nikunja, but holy names with all these lilas, with all these qualities and all these sweetness coming to us. This is the difference, what I see. In same time, Nama Namina Bhinatva, to means Nama, holy name, and the holder of this name, Abhinatva, non-different. But in same time, the holy name is more merciful. Nam Prabhu. Nam Prabhu. It's great, my great hope, because I read here, Ananda Babaji Maharaj told, even just chanting Radha, Radha is the best sadhana. All in her name, all manjari, sadhana, all bhavas, everything in her name. If I will chant Krishna, Krishna, Srimati Radhika will be happy, because I'm telling about her beloved, about her mohan. If I will tell Radha, Radha, then mohan will be happy, he will help me. Recently, Jananda published it in Dasya, Radha Dasya, this story, how Krishna and Srimati Radhika speaking about their love to each other. Krishna telling, why are you so angry with me? If I will become tree, what you will do? She's answering, I will be Lata around this tree, but I will be with you. Okay, but if I will become Yamuna, oh, then I will be the wave in the stream of this Yamuna. I will be always with you.
Wow.
And Krishna then keeping her cheek like this, and Srimati Radhika waiting next question. And he's telling, okay, if I will become a cow, when what will be? Oh, I will be the bell on your neck, but I will be with you, always with you. Then Krishna heard this, he told, oh Radha, if some really chant, will chant your name, your devotee, I will serve this person. And then Radha heard this, she told to him, if someone have really love to you, I will be with always with this person.
Wow.
They're receiving all this by just holy name, it's mercy. Who am I? But I receive it.
Wow.
Every day we come in to our Thakurji and calling Radhe, Radhe, Radhe. And at the end of Kirtan, Radha Mohan, we're singing. I remember how Gurudev on the centenary, not centenary, has called 90 years festival. It was in springtime. How Gurudev singing here, Kirtan Radha Mohan, with such love he's singing. It's like an initiation in Ishtadevatas. When he sing, he gave his attachment, his feelings to Radha Mohan. It's mercy of holy name, Radha.
Very beautiful, Radha Charan Baba, thank you. And my feeling like this. Generally speaking, holy name and say Krishna and Krishna's name, Radha, Radha's name is same. But holy name is more merciful. So one story in Virapaksha Manjari I want to share. So one day, Radha, after Nikunja Lila, after Amara's pastime, Radha Rani become little bit, what to say, little bit like kind of she has a controlling nature. Swadina Bhartrika. So she was saying, hey, Mohan, please do this, please do this. Radha's a little bit demanding. And then Krishna was saying, yes. Krishna sit near Radha Rani's feet. And then Radha said, please anoint my foot rack on my foot. And Krishna saying, yes. And the Manjari bring all the items. So Krishna was so ecstasy, and he want to put red rack on her foot. And then Krishna was feeling, oh my God, actually this foot rack is more fortunate than I. Because this red rack is always with Radhika. But I'm not always Radhika, unfortunately. Then Krishna starts thinking, many devotees say, many authorities say, myself and my name is non-different. So maybe let me write my name, this red rag, on her foot. A Krishna's light name, Sharma or something. And then Torashi Manjari was watching this, this item, but Radhika did not understand. Just Radhika was thinking, just Krishna do, like a painting, red rag. Then Manjari was seeing, and then Manjari is like, and little bit, what's it, jijiru? Kind of smiling. And then Radhika saying, what are you doing? What are you laughing? What are you jiggling? And then Radhika's kick Torashi's shoulder, Torashi's arms. Then foot rack is on her arms, on her shoulder. And then Torashi Manjari so happy, so blissful. I was marked made servant. I may broadcast from Kunja to Kunja, like this. So even Krishna's thinking, actually Krishna's name is more fortunate. Because Krishna's name, if I write Radhika's foot, the holy name is always Radhika. But I'm not like this. But my name and myself is the same. So Krishna feel so much blissfulness. So this is the story of Vrihapaksa Manjari. Same, but also Radha Charanpapa say also, this also merciful. Or if we may commit offense to the deity or commit to Krishna, then if we chant the name, even that offense slowly is going. So therefore, I don't have so much realization, but holy name has including everything. Holy name is Nama, Rupa, Guna, Lila, Seva, holy name, everything including. So therefore, this holy name and Krishna, Krishna and Krishna's name is same. But also same times, I also feel holy name is more merciful. Krishna say holy name is more fortunate. Therefore, in this Kali Yuga, Mahaprabhu told us, Harinama, Harinama, Harinama iba kevaram. Karo nasteva, nasteva, nasteva gatiranyata. In this Kali Yuga, chanting holy name, chanting holy name, chanting holy name is only way to get salvation, get prema. Radhe Radhe.
Yeah. Radhe Radhe, very beautiful. So that we listen, no? Long time ago already, the holy name is more merciful than Krishna himself. Because he don't take the offenses. I also think we cannot direct associate with Radha Mohan. Because we are not pure. But the holy name is ready to associate with us, coming to us, touching us, our tongue. There's a close association with the holy name, with Radha Mohan, that I can have now, even in my state of practice, when I'm not pure. Radha and Mohan we can directly serve only in Swarup. But holy name so merciful, touching me, this Sadak Deha also, if I want to. That is a kind of association that is with us, that is very merciful.
Wow.
I also feel that we listen, Radha Mohan, they never leave Vrindavan. They are always in Vrindavan. But holy name is leaving Vrindavan, coming all over the world, going throughout the universe, throughout the creation. So this both examples are also showing that the holy name actually is more merciful, no? Than Radha Mohan themselves.
So Gaurachandra mentioned, very nice mentioned, because Sadaka Deha, also Siddha Deha, we are chanting. So therefore it mentioned Sadhana and Sadhya, it's same process, chanting holy name. Sadhana means practicing stage, also we are chanting. Also, perfection stage, Siddha stage, also chanting the name. So, Gaurachandra mentioned a very nice point. So, therefore, we are chanting in this Sadaka Deha, also Siddha Deha, also we are chanting. This is a very important point you mentioned, Radhe Radhe.
But in Siddha, we want to chant. We cannot stop it. It comes automatically. In Sadak, we may not have the desire to chant always. Like, but still, name want to come again and associate with me. Although maybe I don't have the desire to chant. No? But holy name still coming to me, associate with me, want to give mercy to me. In Siddha, no problem to chant the names. because greed is there, perfection is there. But in sadhu, it's a little different.
True. Like Keshava Baba. Keshava Baba's chanting is like we are breathing, you know? Keshava Baba's chanting is like breathing. Holy name is coming from lotus mouth. This is like kind of siddha, you know. I don't know, you know, unknowingly, automatically holy name is coming. We are breathing. Sometimes knowingly, sometimes unknowingly we are breathing. I think this siddha stage is like this. Unknowingly, breathing, holy names automatically coming. All leaders automatically coming. That is my feeling, Gaurachandra.
Preaching the glories of the holy name perfects one's surrender to the Lord. The holy name should be chanted with affection and attention. As Srila Jiva Goswami explains in his Krama Sambandha Tikka on Srimad Bhagavat, quote, the holy name can be chanted in two ways, ordinarily or with affection. The ordinary, offenseless chanter will reach the divine abode of the Lord, but the affectionate chanter attains the proximity of the Lord and thereby his personal service. Yeah, I think here is explained the difference between Vairi and Raga. If you chant in the ordinary way without feelings and relation, but offenseless, you will reach the divine abode of the Lord, means Vaikuntha. But if you chant with love and devotion, then you get the personal service. Then you go to Vrindavan. And in our line, Sampradaya, becoming maidservant of Srimati Radhika. Is that correct, Maharaj? Radha Charan?
Hundred percent correct, I feel.
When Sri Krishna came to Kurukshetra, he told the gopis, O Braja Sundaris, devotion to me bestows immortality to the living beings, and your affection for me has forcibly attracted me to you and brought me here. It's the same meaning. Devotion to me bestows immortality, meaning general bhakti, vairi bhakti. But Krishna saying to the gopis, your raga, your love, your passion, attracted me. General devotion don't attract Krishna. The living entity benefits by getting immortality. But calling the name of the Lord with love and affection, with raga, attracts him. Like the gopis called Krishna and he was so attracted that he came to see them. Your affection for me has forcibly attracted me to you and brought me here. Srimad Jiva Goswami has written, loud chanting is the best. And he explains it with scriptural evidence. In Bhakti Sandarbha, quote, those who chant loudly do not only benefit themselves, but also all other living entities. Sri Prahlad tells Sri Nishingadev in the Nishinga Purana, O Lord, those who blissfully and loudly chant your holy name are known as the causeless friends of all living entities. In his Brihat Bhagavatamrita, Srimad Sanatan Goswami says, just as the chataka birds in the rainy season anxiously cry for rainwater, and the chakravaki birds anxiously cry for their husbands at night, the devotees anxiously cry out loud for their Lord during the Harinam Sankirtan. A devotee who sings the name of the Lord with such loving anxiety will very swiftly attain love of God. In this verse, Sripad also shows the desire to lovingly worship the deity with different fragrant paraphernalia. Just as the devotee accepts the syllables of God's name to be his avatar, so he also sees the deity as a merciful avatar. Chaitanya Charitamrita states, Pratima nahe tumi sakshat prajendra nandana. You are not a statue. You are directly the Prince of Braja. When a devotee has such love and faith in the deity, he will surely be blessed. Srimad Jiva Goswami writes in Bhakti Sandarbha, the highest worshippers see the statue of the Lord as being directly God Himself. Their devotion will be broken if they would consider the deity to be different from the Lord. Quote from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Nama vigraha svarupa tina eka rupa tina beda nai tina chit ananda rupa. The name, the deity, and the constitution of God are all one. There is no difference between them. They are all transcendental. There are so many brilliant examples in history of how the deity directly ate the food offered to him by the devotee, how he spoke with the devotees, or went to different places with them just to please them. For the sake of his devotee, Lord Gopala walked from Vrindavan to Vidyanagara in South India. And out of love for his great devotee, King Purushottam Dev of Orissa, he came from Vidyanagara to Cuttack. When the queen saw Sri Gopal, she became desirous to place a valuable pearl in his nose and thought, quote from Chaitanya Charitamrita, if there was a hole in the Lord's nose, this maidservant could have hung a pearl in it. Thinking like this, the queen offered her obeisances to the deity and returned to her palace. But at the end of the night, Gopal appeared to her in a dream and told her, when I was a child, my mother Yashoda made a hole in my nose and carefully hung a pearl in it. That same hole is still in my nose. Put the pearl you wanted to offer in there. Finally, Sripad expresses the desire to live in Vrindavan. It is most blissful to consciously live in Braja, thinking, I am living in Sri Radha's playground. Sri Lataku Mahasaya has sung, Hari Hari, Kobe Mora Hoibe Sudina, Pala Mula Brindavane, Kaya Diva Avasane, Brahmi Bo Hoiya Udasina. Hari Hari, when will that blessed day come that I can wander around in Vrindavan, indifferent towards material circumstances, and eating only some fruits and roots in the evening? Sitala Yamuna Jale Snana Kori Kutuhole Prema Veshe Anandita Hoya Bahu upar bahu tuli, Brindavane kuli kuli, Krishna boli bedabo kandiya. In great loving ecstasy, I will bathe in the cool Yamuna water, and I will wander around in Vrindavan, raising my arms and crying out, Krishna. Dekibo Sanketa Stana, Yudabe Tapita Prana, Prema Veshe Gadagadi Dibo, Kaha Radha Praneshwari, Kaha Girivarada Girivaradari, Kaha Nata Boliya Dakibo. I will soothe my burning heart by seeing Radha and Krishna's meeting place. And I will roll around there in great loving ecstasy, crying out, O Radha, O Queen of my heart, O Lord Girivaradari, where are you? Madhavi Kunjero Pari, Suke Bosi Suka Sari, Gaibik Radha Krishna Rasa, Taru Mule Bosi Taha, Suni Juda Ibehia, Kobe Suke Gova Bodhivasa. The Suka and Sari parrots sit in the Madhavi grove and sing songs about Radha and Krishna's love. I will soothe my heart by hearing them sing, sitting at the foot of a tree. Thus I will blissfully spend the time. Sripad says, let my mind always stay with the soft lotus feet of Sri Radha, practicing these three items of devotion, Nam Kirtan, Archan, and Brajavas. So far for the Sadaka Vesh, external prayers of Sripa. There's also an internal meaning to this verse for Siddhavesh. Sripad, as a kinkari, is serving Sri Radha in Yavat. Sri Radha's agony of separation from her lover simply increases, and when she finally faints, the maidservant revives her by loudly singing Hari's names in her ears. Srila Rupa Goswami writes in Ujjval Nilamani, when Radhika enters a Kadamba forest on the bank of the Yamuna, where bumblebees are singing, she faints. But her girlfriends revive her by loudly singing Hari's name to her. The kinkaris chant the 16-word 32-syllable Hare Krishna Maha Mantra to Sri Radhika, of which there is the following sweet word-for-word explanation. Somebody want to comment on something? Okay. Quote, once Sri Radhika tried to stop the tears, she cried out of separation from Krishna by meditating on him and constantly repeating these names of him. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Nama Shravana Matrena Mama Manoharasi. Hare, you steer my mind when I simply hear your name. Krishna, by playing your flute, you attract me from my house into the forest. Hare, you steal my shame and my patience. Krishna, you attract me with your bodily fragrance. Krishna, with your bodily luster, you attract me and make me greedy. Krishna, with your supreme bliss, you attract me and make me greedy. Hare, you bind me in your arm and take me to a bed of flowers. Hare, there you take off my undergarments. In this way, there's also a very relishable and confidential meaning to the Hare Rama half of the mantra. The Kinkaris try to soothe Sri Radhika's burning pain by singing these names to her and by offering her cooling substances such as sandalwood pulp, camphor, lotus stems, and so. When Radha's girlfriends notice that she still does not regain consciousness, they send the Kinkaris out to find Krishna himself. Only his bodily touch can revive her. That can be another meaning for the phrase Paramanandam in the text. I'm getting Krishna, the pinnacle of transcendental bliss for you from Vrindavan. Sri Shuka Muni also said in Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna, the friend of the Brajbasis, is the most blissful supreme Brahman. The Kinkaris disguise Krishna as a girl and bring him to Srimati in Yavat. Then, when he touches her, she finally regains consciousness. What a great service these Kinkaris are performing. this is the end of the verse 55.
Thank you very much for reading and sharing Mora Chandra and Radha Charan Ji. And is there some comments or sharing if somebody wants to share?
Radha, Radha. Yes, I want to say it's deeply touched my heart, Bhutgara Chandra Say, and all your wonderful explanations. Thank you from my heart, deeply. It's very, very raw and special. Thank you.
Actually, very beautiful Gora Chandra explain. You should talk more.
I will mention at the end, I'm not 100% sure if it is true, but I have the feeling that all these five items that we discussed, somehow they are not different from Radha Mohan himself, themselves. In Shastra also is mentioned that the Guru, the Sadhu, somehow in a way is not different from Krishna. And that Srimad Bhagavatam actually is also the incarnation of the Lord in Shastra, meaning Shastra is also not different. And the Murti, as we listen, the deity is also not different. And the name, of course, is also not different. And also Vrindavan, the Dham is also not different from that. So somehow, all these five most powerful items, practices in bhakti, are not different from Radha Mohan. In a way, maybe Radha Charan, he can give some shastric
yes, I don't want to speak now, but I agree completely because I heard this, how Guru, Sadhu not different from Radha Krishna, how Bhagavatam not different from Radha Krishna, Sankirtana, all what you told, it's, okay. I accept it.
I don't want to speculate on that matter.
It's not speculation.
Okay, thank you very much.